I figured since I was in the process of making a couple of longer videos at the moment, one being the full paint up of this purple Lionel Johnson and another being an army that I'm preparing at the moment to try and paint in a single day, I would just show you guys the process that I went through to create this marble base. I painted the whole thing in just 5 minutes, so I figure, you know, quick and easy video to throw out for you guys. So it's just painted directly over the Games Workshop base. The only prep that I did for it was just sanding it down. If you want, you could prime it black, but I didn't bother to do so. The main tool we're using really is one of these disinfectant baby wipes. Incredibly cheap. I got a packet of 100 of them for $2. And I keep a lot of these around my desk anyway, just for cleaning. You can see I just tease the fibers apart until it looks like it did in the previous clip. I then just used a knife to score some tiles into the base itself. You can use some different tools for this. There's some scale modeling tools that are made to kind of create panel lines, which are better, but this is all I had. I attached it to a little paint holder, and there we go. So you can see the way it's teased apart. You basically, just as I've done, pull it over and hold it tight. That's why I like to use the paint holder. The first color that I'm using is just kind of a test, which I ended up liking. It's one of the Vallejo, the Shifters color shifting paints. I forget the color of it exactly, like the name of the color. But you can see after a couple of thin passes, that's the effect that we get. Once that dried thoroughly, did the exact same thing with a white ink. This is using Liquitex's titanium white. And again, just make sure to do a few thin passes because you don't want to pull any paint and have it bleed underneath the fibers that are kind of covering the effect. And once pulled off, that's the effect we get. I think I actually went over and did another pass of white just to cover a couple more spaces because it looked a little bit too spaced out and I wasn't a huge fan of it. But that's simply the effect. If you want, you can go further and kind of brush paint in some thin veins. I didn't bother to do this because I wanted to just smash this out quickly, but I think I will end up creating a little bit more of a scenic base with, you know, some more steps to it for the lion, just to hold the model to it for the purposes of kind of seeing if the colors work together. I just poked a small hole with the Dremel, same as the pin that I have to hold the lion at the moment on his little painting stand, plugged him in, and yeah, I'm a fan of the way it looks. As I said previously, I am working on a couple of longer videos, so if you like the content, make sure to subscribe. If you like the look of the purple scheme that you're seeing on the lion, the previous video I uploaded is actually exactly how I painted this color scheme, so go check that out if you're keen. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one.